All right, before we get into this video, I want to give a big shout out to RRGraph Design for actually sponsoring this video. And what you see here is the monster slide template. So it has over 1,000+ slides, over 50 sections, free 3D assets, bonus files, including Illustrator files, Photoshop, Canva, and Figma, free icons, drag and drop image placeholders, tons of creative motions, fast support, free future updates, high resolution, easy editable elements, various visual styles, and so much more. It's insane. There's all these different themes, colors. It's super customizable. You guys, I have used RRGraph Design in the past, and I absolutely love the work that they produce. So if you want to win this for free, all you have to do is like this video, subscribe, go show RRGraph Design a lot of support on their Instagram for giving us the opportunity to win this, and 5 of you can win. All you have to do is comment down below as to why you want to win these slides, and after subscribing and like the video, you have a chance. It's simple as that. So without further ado, let's get to the video. And thanks once again for RRGraph Design for sponsoring this video. All right, you guys, in this video, I'm actually gonna be showing you guys a PowerPoint template that I've created. Now, I haven't done PowerPoint videos in a really long time, but a company called Innovo Management reached out to me. They're a social media agency, and they wanted to create a really cool TikTok themed PowerPoint template. So without further ado, let's get to it. All right, so as you can see here, this is the start. This is just a speed view of what I'm designing. So right now, as you can see here, this is the Innovo logo that they have for Innovo Management. And then I'm creating a color palette on the side. So we got Innovo TikTok Marketing. They're trying to promote their marketing services and what they're all capable of doing. And then this is their tagline as well. So I decided to go with this theme because these are similar colors to what their actual company shows on their website. I also have a link to their website in the description below. But as you can see here, I'm just getting a little OCD with it for the title page, adding in some gradients, some nice fonts, some TikTok logos. I recreated their entire logo with just using shapes and yeah, just cleaning it up. So this is now what their ask is for the next slide. And I'm playing around with where not to use the world or something else. And then I come to a conclusion that the theme's gonna be dark. I'm gonna use pink as all the same fonts, and then I'm gonna just play around with different shapes and logos and all that. And so this is just the text that they had, and I'm just rearranging right here with some text boxes. And as you can easily see, I'll create an entire slide and think it's great. You know, think it's all done, think it's all set, and then I may just scrap it and do something completely different. That's what actually happened here. As you saw at first, I had one vision for it, and then I even went back to the first slide. The OCD got the best of me, so that's what happens. All right, so it looks like this is probably gonna be close to what I conclude for the first slide. At least I'm pretty sure. Yep, all right, so now we're moving on to the second one. This one's got a little bit of different information. Usually I don't like that much text on a slide, so I try to add as many visuals as possible. I actually got this visual on the right that you see right here from a template from Essentials. So if you haven't checked out that video already, it's right here. Make sure to check it out. They have an amazing template where you can pick and choose different features and shapes and animations and all this different stuff in their template to put in your own deck, or even use their deck and then just edit it. So I was pulling a couple of visuals from their deck just because I really like the look and feel of it with their visuals. And now we're getting on to a quote slide. So I just put some really big quotes there in the background, super faint, so it doesn't distract people from the actual text I want them to read. And then what are your goals? Again, some light text. And whatever you want to emphasize, make sure it stands out with some color that's way different than most of the slide. Like, the audience's eyes are gonna be drawn immediately to that color and read that maybe first or second, depending on the flow. Obviously, things go from left to right usually for people when they're reading a slide, so just keep that in mind. But if I have goals in pink, they're probably gonna see that first. So as you can see here, again, changing the look and feel of it several times before I come to a conclusion on what I'm actually gonna go with. This is a process, you guys, and it's kind of crazy, to be honest. All right, and then I'm putting in a little target with a gradient color. All right, and also, you guys, I'm doing this all in one take because this is a sped up version of me editing this PowerPoint. So any mistakes I say real time, It's just gonna happen, so that's just what it is. All right, so now I think we're getting on to the next slide. Yep. Again, a lot of information. And whenever I get a lot of text I need to put on a slide, it makes the job somewhat difficult because I have to think, do I actually shorten this text? Do I keep it all in there because it's what the client wants on the slide? Do I add visuals to replace the text? Because when you think about PowerPoint, it really should be telling a story and not have people actually read what's on a slide. You know, it should be a visual aid, but not a book, okay? So I'm trying to add some visuals here. As you can see on the right, I also took this from a template that I got from Essentials. Super awesome company. Again, check them out right here if you are interested in seeing that video. But yeah, I'll have a link to that as well in the description below, a template to it if you are interested. And now I'm just being super crazy and changing all the colors of the actual image so that stays on brand with the pink and the grays and the blacks and all that. Now moving on to the next one. This one was probably one of my favorite slides because it was just nice and simple, big and bold, just getting people excited about the brand. And I almost kind of created their own identity with this slide. This was a little bit out of the box, but they seemed to love it, which was really good. And it just wanted to show movement and, you know, a little bit of creativity with that slide mostly. So not too much information on that one, just really showing, you know, what their brand's all about. All right, this next one, these are kind of like tiles that I had. I also got this from the template and I had to work with this one a lot. As you can see here, I'm probably gonna delete things, add them, reshape them, all that. And you just kind of have to play around with it sometimes. You know, when you're creating a PowerPoint template, you may think you have a certain idea in mind, and then once you're working on it, you're like, oof, that doesn't look as good as I thought. So as you can see here, I'm probably looking at it and then resizing it. And the problem is I have OCD when it comes to designing, and sometimes that's good, sometimes it's bad. It's also why probably sometimes I don't design as often as I would like to, because I can't make up my mind. All right, so for this one, this is just showing all the different projects they did. So I'm pretty much putting in all their different logos and then making them light. You can do this with a color filter in picture format, or just change the saturation to gray. That's also another way of doing it. All right, so now this is one of their case studies, I believe, with Zales. All right, just putting a couple of stats there, trying to figure out which ones I want to emphasize. I'm working with glow a little bit as well. And then just rearranging those boxes as many times, because I'm like, all right, I got four stats there. How do I want to organize them? Do I want them just in like four equal rectangles or what? So as you can see there, I rearranged it several times before I got a look and feel that I really liked with that one. And then all the slides have the information that I need on them and what they're trying to look for. And it's up to me to decide how I'm gonna actually visualize this. So honestly, if you have the content, that's the easiest part of the slide. Actually figuring out how you're gonna make it tell a story or look good or flow nicely and have all the content not be too cluttered and just fit in overall nicely and just in general is probably the toughest part of all of this. So as you can see here, I'm playing around with circles, wanna get, you know, a couple of tiles in the background in the upper right corner. And then now I have Let's Connect. This is their actual email. If you wanna reach out to them and say, hey, I saw Tyler's video, feel free. Okay, and then just adding in their logo, which I made in PowerPoint, which is crazy. I don't even know if the agency knew that I made their actual logo in PowerPoint, recreated it. I didn't actually make it for them, I just recreated it. And then it's just a nice slide in the beginning just to show the color palette, the template, their logo, all that. Just a little bit more professional look and feel as the final product when I send it off to them. And then we got their logo, and yeah. So as you can see, I went through the deck pretty quickly there at the end. If you guys do want to see what the actual slides look like slowed down, I can put a link to it in the description below. Just let me know in the comments if you guys are interested in seeing that. But yeah, this is pretty much the entire template. If you guys did enjoy this speed run of me designing a template for Innovo management, make sure to give this video a like. And if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.